TOMz.
Hello, hello, TOMz, and welcome to yet another exciting, amazing episode of the best science and technology show on TV, brought to you by SABC Education. Kona nana go SABC one mzansi for sure. Mina ke ngusiya.
Kwaye nandi ngubongi sipho namhlanje ke thina sabezi niphathele inqubo eva bichisa. Sifunda all about ecosystem. Now, zinto niganye ganye ecosystem. Zikhona like ecosystem going back. Kwaye sonke we live in one big ecosystem.
Ecosystems are self-contained areas where a wide variety of plant and animal species live and reproduce. They depend on each other and on non-living factors like air, amanzi kanye ne sunlight.
Injalo kaye, now the life and reproduction of all the organisms in an ecosystem depends on the continuing growth and reproduction of the plants, and also on successful interaction between living species.
An ecosystem contains food webs and competition for food among different animals and organisms. And this right here is all part of natural biodiversity. South Africa has amazing biodiversity, which is a mix of many different species all interacting in just one ecosystem. Isn't that just amazing?
Wow, now guys, tell up, we're also taking an in-depth look at all of the biodiversity.
Coming up next, with teenagers on a mission, we find out about a threatened ecosystem up at Johannesburg and what's being done to save it. Sifunda about a species that is an important part of the ecosystem and is endangered, the rhino. We get the lowdown on the best eco-friendly online content, including an awesome eco game you don't want to miss. Kwaeke, we get some great career advice in the field of eco-science.
Humans threaten the ecosystems by producing waste, damaging habitats, and removing too many species without giving the ecosystem ixesha to naturally regenerate.
A healthy ecosystem has a balance of predators and prey that naturally cycle through life and death. This is just one example of how we can affect a natural ecosystem. But ecosystems are so diverse that there are so many ways too. Siya thina siyela phemzansi ukuthi sithole nini ukuthi ngabangani about the natural system. Let go.
Okay, ngifuna ukuyena, what is ecosystem? Ecosystems in nature, in the broad view, ne?
Like a habitat, you know, where living organisms, like ants, human beings, like we all gather there.
I think ecosystem is how organisms in our environment interact with each other.
Cool. So, Poyngfunu Kiana, what is our role in the ecosystem?
Our role in the ecosystem world is to try and preserve it.
Our role in the ecosystem, I think, is to help preserve it so that animals in the ecosystem cannot go extinct and stuff. Yes.
Our own well-being as abantu all depends on how we interact with the ecosystem. And it is up to us to work at sustainable solutions for protecting our natural resources like water, trees, and lezinto lezi provide ngani oxygen.
Yonke into ke sithi sell as well as consume all comes from the earth. Kwaye bathina sisebenzisa njani as resources wisely, ibaleke kakhulu to the survival of the system.
With populations growing all around the world, the demand for food and clean water is also growing. And our actions are damaging many ecosystems to meet these demands.
Now, we are only one of many species on the planet, and just by being here, we actually interact with plants, animals, and the environment around us. Now, here's a quick look at how ecosystems work.
Ecosystem includes all of the living things like plants, animals, and other organisms in the area, interacting with each other, and also with non-living things like weather, earth, sun, soil, climate, as well as the atmosphere. So the ecosystem is like a community, with every plant, animal, and organism has a role to play. Some ecosystems are very large and some are cool. They can exist in small areas like underneath rocks, in a tree trunk or a pond, or in places like rainforest or the Kruger National Park if they're bigger. Umzekelo, plants absorb energy from sunlight and fertilized soil and provide it to animals and eat them. As nyege animals eat those animals and the energy transfers to them. As okay, animals then fertilize the soil with their waste, transferring energy back to the plants. So yonke into in an ecosystem is connected in the life cycle, and every part of the cycle is important.
Grasslands cover 30% of South Africa's land area in 6 provinces. Why is the higher to South Africa's major economic, agricultural, industrial, and urban centers?
6.4 million cattle and 13 million sheep graze the area, which in ecological science is called a biome.
In Jalokaya, now grasslands are the breadbasket of South Africa, providing the coal that feeds our power stations and agricultural produce as diseases.
And in Jalokaya, there are projects on the go to preserve our grassland.
And of course, I'm going to mention it, but we just touched down at Pretoria of Vashela, at SABC Botanical Gardens, about grassland. Are you ready to learn more? Because I am. You, me, let's get it.
Sesifikile lapha futhi la iSandby Botanical Gardens ePitori sofinda kabanzi about ecosystems. Hlelini noTep is going to tell us more about that. Kunjani kutwami?
Shabu njani
mfethu? Shabu shabu. Welcome to TOMz.
Thank you.
Okay, so ngitshele mfethu, what is grassland?
Well, grassland ke ndawo yeleng hore it's only natural occurring vegetation but okay. dominated by grass, hence okay. grassland. Yeah. Okay. You can have a grassland with a couple of trees, mm-hmm. maybe two or three, but it's still called a grassland.
So kungani siyidingi grassland?
We derive a lot of things from grassland, mm-hmm. like thatch roof is made of grass, a grass called Hibernia heath, mm-hmm. which is its scientific names, because grasses also have scientific names and common names. You have a mango tree,
okay.
You have a banana tree, you have an apple tree. Mm-hmm. So same goes with the grass. This one, they have different names.
Okay.
As you can see, I've got these two grasses. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to see that these grasses. Exactly, yeah. Exactly. So this one also has its name, and this one has its name.
Okay, so Ngjel, in fact, how does grassland become part of the ecosystem?
Well, it's part of ecosystem because there are animals mm-hmm. that are only found in grassland. If you were not to have grasslands, then it means those animals won't exist.
Why is it important for us to be educated about it?
It's a habitat of other animals. Only animals only get in grassland. But still, only a lot of food we get from grassland, wheat, pigs, corn, and we do eat them on a daily basis.
Okay, so Tapong Jet again, what's the main reason for what's in the grassland?
It's just to educate people about the importance of grasslands.
Okay.
Because grasslands do not only have the animals that live there, but they also help with limiting erosion in the soil. Because when you have grass, and if the grass is to permit the earth. And also, when there's a lot of rain, especially when there's no concrete or anything, grass it is the running water is going to erode maybe the house. If let's just say you have a house here and there's a slope. Like the water is coming down from that slope. Over time that house is gonna be eroded. But when you have grass in front of that, then it helps like lower the amount of water that passes. Yeah, or it's gonna cause the dongas like mango person. Yeah, so that's one of the things that grasses do help with. They limit the amount of water, run of water. Yes.
So noma ikuphi la ohlala khona, take a moment ukuthi ucabange ngalo kudla okudlayo namanzi futhi owaphuzayo and all the animal and plant life around you. It's all just as important as you are.
Injalo kanye ke siyena, we are all part of the natural system and yonke into esiyenzayo ingathi incanje kaloku to conserve our natural resources.
Ngisengempela okwamanje ke sathi sishelele kancane etolo wadla ke bese sibuya sinphathele okuningi ungayindawo.
Xa will be finding out about an important species in the African ecosystem, the rhino. Uhlala uhleli kaloku wena because awufuni pause.
TOMz. TOMz.
Students, I'm going to get to another exciting TOMz show. You teenagers on a mission in a bit, and you can be like SABC 1. Mzansi for sure alone.
What you're going to do in Amtana is all about how every living thing, including Tinabantu, fits into an ecosystem.
Injalo kanye, now just think about the ecosystems that might exist in your neighborhood or even in your own yard. Now, if you have a vegetable garden, the plants attract plant eating insects.
Mm-hmm. Now, le nambuzane lezi attracts birds, snakes, and frogs, and all these animals might attract predators like cats or mongoose and owls, and that right there is just an ecosystem just outside your door.
Now, spina ke isilwanyana that is in an ecosystem idlala indima ebaluleke kakhulu ku life cycle. The rhino is one animal that is at risk, and because it's at risk, a whole ecosystem could suffer.
Ngithakukhulu nabongisipho, by forcing through thick shrub and forest like a tank, rhinos open up access for other species, and by continuously browsing shrubs and small trees, rhinos shape the way that they grow up and keep them short and accessible to a whole range of smaller leaf eaters.
Injalo kanye, now this is just part of why conserving the rhino is important to the natural ecosystem. Sisahamba ke sayibuthela the Johannesburg Zoo to find out more detail about this protected species. Check it out.
Lebitso la ka ke Alice Masombuka, remote Johannesburg Zoo. Mosebetsi wa ka ke sebetsa ka diphoofolo tsa tshwana le bo di rhino, di African hippo le di elephant. mosebetsi wa ka go di hlokomela. Rhino conservation ke go hlokomela di rhino ka gore rhino di na le bothata tsa gore batho ba di bulaya ka poaching, and then tshwanetse re di hlokomele gore di tlo ba teng le di generation tse di tlang re kgone go di bona le rute bana ba rena ka ga tsona. So go na le diphoofolo tse leng di na le mathata a mangata tse dingwe di a jewa, tse dingwe di a bolaiwa. So he re di conserve re kgone go tloba le tsona mengwageng e e tlang. Naga ya rena e tlhaa ka maatla go conserve di rhino, go ba le di legislation tse e leng gore melao e ba irang go ya le dinaga tse dingwe. Ka gore taba ya rhino poaching ga se ntho ya South Africa fela, ke dinaga ka ofela tsa Africa, dinaga tsa bo Asia, mo go le gore batho ba kopana from dinageng tse di farologaneng ba bolaya di rhino go rekisa lenaka la tsone. So naga ya rena ya South Africa e tiisa melao, maponisa le bona ba tiisa melao ka mo le melao, dikgotho di tiisa melao gore batho ba ba dirang dintho tsa go bolaya di rhino ba kgone go tshwariwa. Le rena re le batho ba ba berekang ka diphoofolo di rhino tse re kgone go ruta batho ka tsona botlhokwa ba tsona, le gore he e le gore go na le o tseba motho ya dirang ntho e ya bo ya di rhino o kgona go leletsa mogala o tsebise ba seponisa, o tsebise le ba molao. Rhino e important mo ecosystemeng ka lebaka la gore di rhino ke diphoofolo tse e leng gore di a epa. He di epile, he di pula dina, go ba le melete mo e leng gore di gwagwa di kgona go dula ka mogare ga tsona. Di rhino di na le dikokwana tse e leng gore di a mela mo mmeleng. Dinonyane di kgona go ja dikokwana tse di leng mo mmeleng ya di rhino. So ga go senang di rhino, diphoofolo tsa go tshwana le bo digwagwa, dinonyane di tlile go ba le se se di ka se kgoneng go phela mo go tsona. Di rhino di na le role e ngata as an umbrella species. Di umbrella species ke diphoofolo tse e leng gore di okametse diphoofolo tse dingwe. Ka ge le tseba rhino e re the second largest land mammale mo gare ga ecosystem. Ha re tseye go tshwana le di black rhino di dula mo go kitlhaneng. Ge go fitlha mo sekgweng di kgona go feta mo di bula ditsela. Diphoofolo tse nnyane di kgona go latela mo ditseleng tse di kgona go tswa. Diphoofolo tsa go tshwana le bo di rhino, di white rhino tse di gore di jajang. Ge di tsamaya di ntse di tlosa mantla a tsona mo tlhageng, bojwang bola bo mela gape bo boa gape wa mela, di ba di-fertilizer gape mo nageng. So di na le role e ngata e le gore diphoofolo tse dingwe ge di se teng di tlile go kgona le tsona di tlile go safara di sa kgone go phela gantle. Se se botlhokwa gore tlhokomela ecosystem ka gore phoofolo e nngwe le nngwe e leng ka mogare ga ecosystem e na le se re se bitsang gore is a niche. Niche e tshwana le profession, tshwana re na le matitšhere, re na le di-doctor, le yona go na le se role e ngata e leng gore ya e tshameka ka mogare ga ecosystem. So ga re tlhokomela ecosystem dilo ka ofela di ba balance, diphoofolo ka ofela di kgona go dira mosebetsi wa tsona, di dira tsona ka mo di tshwanetseng gore di be ka teng, and then go sena e nngwe e leng gore e a sotlega ka lebaka la gore e nngwe e be ene e tshwanetse go ba e fitse space se se rileng ga eo. The rhino mo go rena South Africa e na le boleng ka ga re e bona e le e nngwe ya diphoofolo tse e leng gore mo go rena ke identity a re bo rena. Re kgona go e bona le mo gare ga ditšhelete tsa rena mo go 10 rand, rhino ya rena e na le boleng ba 10 rand e teng moo. Rhino re kgona gore ge o ile mafatsheng a mangwe, ge o le motho o tswa o le Africa, ba kgona go associate le di rhino ka re rena re le mo Africa re na le di rhino tse ngata go feta dinageng tse dingwe. So ke heritage ya rena e tshwanetse gore e pele ka yona ka gore e le botlhokwa maphelong a rena.
The rhino is an umbrella species which basically protects other species in the ecosystem, like the umbrella protects you from the rain. Because there are millions of species involved, it can be useful to use umbrella species to make conservation decisions. A rhino, like all other animals, exists within the ecosystem and a biological environment made out of all the animals and plants living in a particular area, as well as the non-living physical parts of the environment, like moya, soil, water, and sunlight. Organisms within the ecosystem are linked and impact each other, and this is why conservations of species like the rhino impact the whole ecosystem, including abantu. So when you save a rhino, you save an ecosystem.
Wonke gama rhinos like wallowing in dirt and will dig deep to create wallows for themselves. These then become used by many different species for bathing and drinking.
Injalo kaya, now rhinos are great diggers and they excavate minerals from the ground using their horns and feet. Now all of this provides an important service for those species who can't open up the earth.
This is just one example of how one animal can affect a whole ecosystem.
Injalo kaya, now imagine how we can affect the environment around us by using natural resources like amanzi and farmland.
You're something to think about indeed. Go manje guys, it's a commercial break, so we're gonna manage.
Now we go glandelayo, we go back in time clockwise to find out about the history of ecological science. We check out some amazing online content with cyberspace, no Mr. Caddy. Kwaeke, we get some awesome career advice. Siyabuye.
TOMz, SABC 1, Zanzi for sure, Sipalunga, but Kolumkin, but Sinti Dankis, Yavo.
I'm telling you guys, Funiga Banzi, all about natural and man made ecosystems and how everything we do is part of a life cycle affecting the environment around us.
Injalokanye, go back when I hear a post on I do now, stress color because you can get a website, Uti, some Tugata as Tevich, Waikunga, Balgalo, Timananat, Kumachelo, Tomnat, Samakas, Facebook, Twitter, and who knows, Natata now, up and come in, Nantlaji.
Isayensi kayo nesisitshengisa okuningi kakhulu about natural systems and how every organism affects its environment, from plants to animals to thina abantu, but we didn't know so much. Kodwa ke iminyaka ye-research has taught us all that we know namhlanje.
Injalo kaya, now the science of ecology has been studied for centuries. Kwaye mna ndicinga uba ngoku ixesha sikhe sihambe man for a little trip in the little machine of clockwise to find out a bit more. Check it out.
The study of ecology goes all the way back in the 4th century. One of the first ecologists is said to be Aristotle, and his student Sako Theophrastus. Both of them had interest in many species of animals and plants. Theophrastus described interrelationships between animals and the environment as early as the 4th century BC. Throughout the 18th century and the beginning of the 19th century, the great powers like Britain, Spain, and Portugal launched expeditions to several other countries looking for natural resources. And I'm a scientist, Bawahamba Nabo. German explorer Alexander von Humboldt was one of the scientists who joined these expeditions, and he is considered a father of ecology, namhlanje. He categorized many plant species that were not known until then, and is one of the main reasons that we have now over 400,000 known plant species, namhlanje. Each of which is part of a bigger ecosystem.
Yo, 400,000 is a lot of plants. I don't think there's any way you could memorize that many in a bunk.
Sazagaluk say you'd have to have a super brain to do that. But yeah, it just proves how diverse the life on planet is. Now there are life forms and organisms. I think as you know, Saz.
Every day. Maybe it's a good idea to go online every day and discover one new species of plant or animal every day.
And yeah, as always, we have been hunting the internet for the coolest online content that you can check out from the comfort of home. That's because I'm a little bit of caddy. Now I'm about to cyberspace.
When cities are built, it's not always easy to build while preserving natural ecosystems and the environment. With the Inner City Games at www.innercities.eu, you can rise to the challenge of building a sustainable city while protecting the ecosystem and the natural environment. How great is that? And if you want to unlock the eco-scientist in yourself, vakashela www.projectnoah.org. Project Noah is a tool to explore and document wildlife and a platform to harness the power of amateur scientists everywhere. You can use it in a document and share information about ecosystems and wildlife in your own backyard. How awesome is that? And for more awesome games and eco challenges, vakashela www.ecokids.ca. Eco Kids is an environmental education website that offers colorful interactive games, activities, and informational pages. It is well organized, covering many key topics in environmental education, including energy, waste, and climate change.
Don't you just love the technology when I see
it? It is amazing when I'm on Isifunga Ngitshele. There's so much great science knowledge on the World Wide Web. And Sifunda Ukushaka Banzi every single day, and all we need is a phone or a computer.
Injalo kwaye kwaye ukufunda is something that you need to keep doing, especially if you want to go into the right career one day. Since ke inkqubo yethu namhlanje has been about ecosystem and ecological science, sesihamba saqhoba uba uma wena ufuna uba eco-scientist, wenza njani? Check this out.
Ecologists are environmental biologists as it gets defined the interactions between organisms and the environment and between organisms themselves. Uma ke wena ampekhaya ufuna ufuna ecology uzawudinga a national senior certificate with university entrance. Now each university will have its own minimum entry requirements. Got your compulsory subjects are maths and physical science. Life sciences is also recommended. There are many areas of ecology that you can study. Many ecologists begin their study career by completing a BSc degree first before specializing in a specific field of ecology. A BSc can be done at most universities in South Africa, and then in your fourth year of study, you can specialize in a specific field. Ukuze ke wena ufumane inkcukacha ezithe vetshe, ungaya ku www.saiees.org.za.
Keep browsing the web and keep studying because there's a career out there just for you. All it's going to take is dedication and ukusebenza ngokuyikhandla.
Injalo kanye, and there are lots of careers out there, and maybe you've thought about a career in conservation, which can help us protect our valuable resource.
Ake hlangane ke nabavakashi bethu ukuthi wena ungathola kanjani advice elungile about yona lento le.
I'm sure you guys have been asking yourself for what is it that you can study so that you become one of the specialists that are able to take care of the environment. So you can study Koskolong, the learners grade 10, 11, and 12 can have life science, geography, maths, and physics, obviously English. Kova City can study nature conservation. I studied nature conservation. You can study some other universities, they call it biodiversity conservation.
After usno dira matric wa gago gona le dikhoso tse di dirwang go di technicone gona le dikhoso tse di dirwang go di university gona le khoso re bitsang a nature conservation. Nature conservation go ya ka gore wena o e dira mo kae e ge o e dira le mo technicone like technicone ya go tshwana le bo matitubo mangosuthi di technicone tse e leng gore o kena full time o e dira mengwaga e mebedi go be le ngwaga wa boraro mo o tla yang mo go di game reserve o ile go ithutela go ira practical ya go ithutela ka diphoofolo.
Oh yebo yes, but fitness film my social sessions were to last khuluma nawe lapha ekhaya sizokuthi wena ubuthini ku Facebook nako Twitter usitshele bonke ukuthi siphethe ba kuphi
ku Facebook sinolibe uhang Ignatius Sihole uthi kena guy like your topic but I want to study physiotherapy. What should I do? Siya khanceda apa please.
Well, it is lento le nga online research more about physiotherapy or you can just keep watching it TOMz and kwazi bani shakhe just khulume ngayo le physiotherapy le career ufuna ukwengena kuyo every man is in choose a corner la ku SABC 1 go 4 bebe funa ukufanela naye benze njani.
Facebook is corner siku TOMz as well as Twitter at TOMz_SABC_1 na ku Instagram at TOMZ_TV_SABC1 keep tweeting. And that's us for today, Gebatan with TOMz. Now we've had an awesome time hanging out with you guys, and we'll be back for more Kumkubu Yotelanda Live.
Facebook and Twitter. Do not forget to check out the TOMz website for more info on the show.
Injalo kanye, so we'll see you back here for the next episode of TOMz. And CBS and Moen Club. Until then, bye-bye.
Bye.
Up next on TOMz. How exactly does the whale make life more convenient? Who is using Ulwaz like of Amavili and Axles to do something really cool. So wonder how much work actually goes into making sure that Amavili on Imoto are good enough to be on the road. Kwayeke, we check out some awesome apps for your mobile. Ungalibalike wena ke ukubukela uTOMz qho ngemivulo nangolwezibini ngensimbi yesine apha ku SABC 1 Mzansi for sure.